Archbishop Hebda has reinstated the Sunday Mass obligation starting on July 1st in Minnesota. This date marks the end of the dispensation. This also marks the end of our drive-up communion. We will only be offering drive-up communion through the end of June. St. Paul reminds us in the second reading that Christ died so those who live might live no longer for themselves. What we give to and do for others, we give to and do for Jesus. At this time, I would like to invite you to please stand and greet those with whom you are worshiping. Please join us in singing our gathering song. It may be found in the Gather Book at number 685. How can I keep from singing?
Happy Father's Day, fathers. We have an image. Oh, that's called a guardrail. Not the road, the rail. That's what the gospel is about. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Spirit be with you all. And we ask God to heal our world, our nation, our church, our parish, our families, ourselves.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And we sing our hymn of praise.
Thank you.
us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands? When I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stilled.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him so no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. A great prophet has risen in our midst. God has visited his people. Alleluia, alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even the wind and sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sundays, Saturdays, weekends of ordinary time are to teach us week by week one and another lesson about how to live this Christian life. Today's lesson is about control. Control. Remember that guardrail? Oh, there it is. Tiger Woods would love to have had a guardrail. He went off the road in a ditch and a tree. last week we heard our president was in Europe. He and others were hoping that the NATO would have guardrails so he wouldn't make a misstep, nor any of the rest of the leaders, what, eight leaders? They would have had some protection against misstep. Same was true for the leaders of EU, the European Union. A lot of talk about guardrails. We need to find a guardrail. Is there a guardrail? Do you have a guardrail? The reporters are always asking that, wanting to be protected from an accident. Now you're saying, that doesn't sound like the gospel to me. Guardrails? But I think that's what Jesus was about in the boat with the apostles when the storm came up and there were no guardrails. The apostles were thrown into consternation because they were in the middle of a storm. So they pleaded with Jesus. Doesn't it bother you that we're being drowned? The apostles said. Calm. Control. No control. Out of control. In a storm. Calmed winds. Control. And I think that has something to do with fatherhood. This is Father's Day. What does that mean? Those who study us say, if a flamboyant child objects to a parent's rules to such extent that the parent says, okay, do whatever you want. No control. Out of control. Those who study us say that young one is somehow going to rebel in a bigger way. If I push against the rules and the rules give, I'm in trouble, the young person says. If the parents control doesn't have to be controlling, just be in control. No, the rules are going to hold, son, and you're going to follow them. Why? Because I said so. It's like that. Has any parent ever got to that point? I think so. One parent nodded, yes, I remember. So there's some rules. Oh, yeah? There's some rules that help life. And I think that's what the scriptures are about. God is saying, were you there when they set the world to spinning? No. Job, or whoever he's talking to. Do you know where life comes from in the world? No. Because God is in control, not controlling. There's a lot of ways that the world spins on and we spin with it. But there are also ways that there are rules. Over the library in Chicago, there's a saying It says, those who would control nature must obey it. Aha. Try that. There are some laws that give us a feeling of being controlled in a good way by God. God's rules, nature's rules. The laws of nature hold. If we mess with them, it's at our peril. Just as a young person bumping up against the rules of family life in some exorbitant way is going to pay a price. Not if the rules hold. Not to be controlling by the family rules, but to be controlled. Security. Control is the lesson of our scriptures today. Let's stand and share our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, for our salvation, came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy God. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world. The Lord be with you. Trusting in the Lord who calms our fears and anxieties, we turn to him to calm the storms that this world endures.
For the church and its leadership, may they continue to guide us as shepherds and caregivers, always welcoming the people of God with mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a peace and just world, one that especially protects children and all who are vulnerable, focusing on repentance, redemption, and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who gather in the midst of chaos and conflict, may we continue to turn to the Lord of life and trust in his goodness and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Owen, who is to be baptized after this Mass, may he grow in the love of Jesus through the example of his parents, his family, and his faith community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For birth fathers, adoptive fathers, expectant fathers, fathers of children far away, for fathers who weep and mourn for their children, for all men who have nurtured life, and for all fathers who have gone on to new life with Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This week, all the priests of the diocese will be in Winona, at St. Mary's University, for every other year conference of the priests, and we pray for that meeting. God, you have created the earth and all it contains and bestowed it as a gift upon humankind. Hear our prayers that each day we might grow in faith, and hear these our prayers and those of our archdiocese. Loving God, who gave Saint Joseph to Jesus and Mary as protector and guide, grant that our Archdiocesan Synod, under his protection and guidance, may help us discern your direction for our church. May we listen as he listened, trust as he trusted, obey as he obeyed, receive as he received, love as he loved, and share in his life of devotion to Jesus and Mary. Amen. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Mary, Mother of the Church, pray for us. Let's be seated as we prepare our table.
Please turn to number 645 and join us in singing our song of offering, Amazing Grace, at number 645.
Friends, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to the God who cares for us. May the Lord. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sin may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And now the church prays. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and all your ministers. Remember your servants, the people of this parish. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And now let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord. Thank you.
Please turn to number 930 and join us in singing Taste and See at number 930.
Stand. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord. so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord. A blessing for fathers. And the rest of us will extend our hands toward them. May God, who gives life on earth and in heaven, lead all who offer a father's love, especially these fathers, to walk by the light of faith and so lead their children to attain the good things that God has promised. In your wisdom and love, you made all things. Allow the faith and love of our fathers, living and dead, to shine forth today and always. May we bear witness to their love, honoring them today and all the days with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this blessing through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
And as we go forth, please turn to number 689 and join us in singing Though the Mountains May Fall at number 689.